Hi guys, so in this video we are going to solve the two problems related to the mesh analysis. Okay, so it's a December 2017 question. So the first question, you see, determine the current I delivered by the source. So this is a given circuit. So in the given circuit, so it is a three mesh circuit, three loop circuit. So here the battery is given as 10 volt battery. So the question is to determine the current I. So where the current I is marked, that is the current supplied by this battery, that is the total current we have to find out. Okay, so in order to solve this problem, so we may use different methods. Okay, so that is one method is to, so here the question is not mesh current, the question is to only the current I. Okay, this total current I we have to find out. But in order to find out the total current, so we have to reduce this entire circuit by one voltage source in series with the total resistance. Okay, so you see this diagram. So using the reduction technique, either series parallel combination or star to delta or delta to star and any method, so we make a reduce this this complex network into one single total resistance, okay, in series with the voltage source. And now the current, the question is, what is the current supplied by this battery? According to this diagram, what is the current supplied by the battery? The current I is equal to the total voltage divided by the total resistance. So 10 divided by RT. Okay. So in this method, we may solve this problem. Okay. It is a one thing. Or another one, using mesh analysis, we can solve the same problem. Okay. So by mesh analysis, you know, so how many meshes are there in the given circuit? Three meshes. So this is the first mesh, this is the second one, and this one is the third one. But let us consider the current I1, I2 and I3. But now the question is to current flowing through this 5 ohm resistor. But we have to find out only the current I1. Okay, so we have to write the 3 KVL equation. So by solving the 3 KVL equation, you just obtain the current I1. It is enough in order to derive the value of I. Okay, that is another one method. Okay, so in nodal analysis itself, we can solve. Okay, we have to write. So you see, how many nodes are there? Two nodes. This is one node and this is one node. So before that node, we have to write the branch currents and we have to apply KCL to each branch and we can solve this current I. Okay, so in any method, we can solve this problem. So but here, I am going to explain the two methods in order to solve this I. One is using the reduction method. Okay, using the reduction method, this network reduction method, we are going to solve the current I. And another method, using mesh analysis, how can you obtain this value I? Okay, in same method, we will get the same answer I. Okay, so we will see one by one. So first one, so in the first method, we are going to reduce this entire circuit by one single resistance using network reduction method. Okay, so already we solved 3-4 problems in network reduction methods. Okay, but in this network reduction method, you see, so we have to reduce this network. Okay, you see the 5 ohm, 10 ohm, 7, 6, 3, 3 is connected in some nature. So we have to reduce the network from the opposite direction. So we have to reduce from this last to first one. Up in the last thing, you see, what are the, this 3 ohm and 3 ohm, these two 3 ohm resistance are connected in series combination. Okay, so but this 3 and 3, we can, this, you see, the first step, so this 3 and 3, it is connected in series combination. But we have to add these two value in order to obtain one single resistance. So the 3 plus 3, it is said to be the 6 ohm. So now the diagram is simplified into the 10 volt battery, 5, 10, 7, 6 and 6. But now see, you see this circuit. But in this circuit, these two 6 ohm resistance are connected in which combination? Parallel combination. Okay. So but you see, the 6 ohm parallel combination with this 6 ohm, we can calculate it as 6 into 6 divided by 6 plus 6. So the answer is 3. Okay. So you just replace these two parallel combination resistance by the single resistance 3. Okay. So already in that thing, there is a 7 ohm resistor there and 10 ohm and 5 ohm you just connect. Okay. Then the next step is to, you see, now in this diagram, this 7 ohm resistor and 3 ohm resistor are connected in series combination. But in series combination means, you know, you just add the two values. So 7 plus 3, it is a 10 ohm resistor. Okay. So now the next reduced diagram is, so 5 ohm, 10 ohm and 10 ohm. But you see this 10 ohm and 10 ohm now connected in parallel combination. So what is the parallel combination of these two resistance value? 10 into 10 divided by 10 plus 10. So the answer is 5 ohms. Okay. So then the next diagram is reduced to this parallel combination. You just replace it with one single resistance of 5 ohm. But now you see this 5 and 5, it is connected in series combination. So series combination means you just add. So 5 plus 5, the answer is 10 ohms. Okay. So but now the diagram is reduced to one single resistance. So this 10 ohms, it is said to be the R total or R equivalent. Okay. So now the question is to find the current I delivered by the particular battery 10 volt. But now according to Ohm's law, so in a, it is a single circuit, okay, single loop circuit. But in this thing, the current I is equal to, it's a ratio of voltage divided by the total resistance. So the voltage is 10 volt and the resistance value is 10 ohm. So 10 divided by 10, it is said to be the 1 amps. Okay. So the current supplied by the particular source, it is I is 1 amps. Okay. This is a one method. And we are going to solve the same problem in mesh analysis. Okay. So in this analysis also, we will get the same answer. But you see, this is the given circuit. So in the given circuit, what is our aim? Our aim is to find out the current, this current I. Okay, in question itself, the current I is mentioned. We have to find the current I. But what is this current I? This current I is said to be current flowing through this 5 ohm resistor. So now we are going to solve this problem in mesh analysis. So you know, what is the procedure in mesh analysis? First, we have to identify the number of meshes. So how many meshes in the given circuit? 3 meshes. And we have to mark the mesh current. So here I am taking all currents in a clockwise direction. So this is the current I1, this is the current I2, and this one is the current I3. Okay. So now our aim is to find out I. According to this diagram, what is I? I is nothing but I1. Okay. So the only thing is we have to find out the value of I1 only. Okay. So in order to solve the I1, first we have to apply the KVL equation to this mesh 1. So, you know the KVL equation. What is KVL equation? In any closed path, the algebraic sum of all voltages is equal to zero. Or otherwise, the sum of voltage rise is equal to sum of voltage drop. Okay, that's the thing. But you see, if you are starting here, means it's a minus to plus. So, minus to plus is said to be the voltage rise. So, 10 equal to what is the current flowing through the 5 ohm resistor? I1. Okay. So what is the voltage drop across the 5 ohm resistor? 5 into I1. Okay. Plus, what is the current flowing through the 10 ohm resistor? Here, the 10 ohm resistor is connected in between I1 and I2. So I1 is flowing this direction. I2 is flowing from low bottom to top. So both the currents are reverse direction. So what is the voltage drop across the 10 ohm resistor? It is at 10 into I1 minus I2. Okay. In this equation, you just recollect the term I1 and I2. But here 5 I1, here 10 I1, so 15 I1 minus 10 I2. It's a equation number 1. Similarly, we have to apply the KVL equation for mesh 2. So 7 into I2 plus 6 into I2 minus I3 plus 10 into I2 minus I1 equal to 0. Okay. So you collect the term. You have to make it as a equation number 2 and apply KVL to mesh 3. Okay. So in mesh 3, 3 into I3 plus 3 into I3 plus 6 into I3 minus I2. Okay. 6 into I3 minus I2 equal to 0. So you collect the term. So now we will get the three equations. So we have to solve this three equation, either substitution method or matrix method. So here the matrix method is easy to solve. So the first one, we have to write the equation number 1, equation number 2, and equation number 3 into matrix form. So you know the method how to write this matrix from this equation. Okay, the first, in first row, the first row is related with the first equation. So the first term is the coefficient of I1, it is 15. The second one is the coefficient of I2, it is minus 10. So in the first equation, there is no I3 term, so it is 0. Okay, similarly, we have to write the second row and third row. Okay, with the constants here 10 and 0 and 0. So but from this thing, you just determine the determinant value del. Okay, you have to find out the determinant value. Then here we want to find I1 current only. So that's why we have to calculate del I1. So what is del I1? The del I1 is nothing but in the 3 by 3 matrix, you just replace this first column by this constant value 10, 0, 0. Okay. So by here 10, 0, 0 and the remaining thing. So from this, you just calculate the determinant value. It is 2400. Okay. So the del I1 is a 2400 and the del is also a 2400. But here, therefore, the current I1 is equal to, it's the ratio of del I1 divided by del. So the 2400 divided by 2400, it is a 1 amps. Okay. So this current I1 is nothing but that's the current supplied by the source. Okay, you see this answer. Okay, in mesh analysis we solved the answer for I is 1 amps. Okay, so in the network reduction method also, okay, in this method also we got the answer is 1 amps. Okay, so in any method you can solve the same problem in a correct procedure, means we will get the same answer only. Okay, so you may use this method or this method. Okay, since in the question, they are not mentioning the method. Okay, simply the question is to determine the current I delivered by the source. So that's why we may use any method. But in some question, if the method is mentioned, that is determine the current I delivered by the source using mesh analysis or using nodal analysis or using network reduction method, means we have to use that particular method only. Okay, so this is the thing about this problem. Okay. And the second problem, so the next problem we are going to see. So it is a December 2017 question and 13 mark question. Okay, so determine the current supplied by each battery in the circuit using mesh analysis. Okay, so here the method is mentioned. Okay, using mesh analysis, the method is mentioned. So we have to use the mesh analysis only. Okay, so what is the question means here? Determine the current supplied by each battery. So you see the diagram. In the given diagram, how many batteries are there? 5 batteries are there. Okay, this is the battery E1, E2, E3, E4 and E5. So all values are given. E1 is 20 volt, E2 is 5 volt, E3 is 5, E4 is 5 and E5 is 30. Okay, so the question is to current supplied by each battery we have to calculate. Okay, using mesh analysis. In the first mesh analysis, first we have to identify the number of meshes. So how many meshes are there in the given diagram? 3 meshes. Okay. So here in the diagram itself, the arrow, the current direction is given, or otherwise you can choose your direction. Okay. So here, so that is whenever we are taking the current direction, we have to see the battery polarity. So always the current which emerged from the positive terminal of the battery. Okay. But here the battery 20 volt is there. And the 5 volt battery is there. So which battery is having highest value? 20 volt. You can choose the current direction depending upon this higher value battery. Okay, so that's why the current is emerging from this positive terminal of the battery. So this current you have to consider as a I1. Similarly, in the second loop, there are 3 batteries are there. One 5 volt, 5 volt and 5 volt batteries are there. So here the current direction is given as in clockwise direction. So in the third, there are 2 batteries are there. One is 30 volt battery, one is 5 volt battery. So the current direction we have to choose according to the higher value of the battery. But here 30 volt is the higher voltage. So that's why the current direction you have to, that current, it will emerge from positive terminal of the battery. That's why anti-clockwise direction. Okay. So the 3 currents are mentioned. So the next step is to, we have to apply KVL to each mesh. Okay. So we will get the 3 equations. So we have to solve that equation. We have to find out the value of I1, I2, I3. Then after that, we have to find out the current supplied by each battery we have to find. Okay. That is the procedure. So the next step is to apply KVL to loop 1. You see, for loop 1, the battery minus to plus, it is a voltage rise 20. So 20 equal to 5 into I1, it's a drop. And 3 into I1 minus I2, it's also a drop. And when we are coming here, plus 2 minus. So you see, plus 2 minus mean higher potential to lower potential. It is also a drop. So the voltage drop you have to write in this side also. Okay, this side itself. So from this constant, you give it to left side. So 20 minus 5 equal to, you split the term, 8I1 minus 3I2. So this is the equation number 1. Okay, similarly, apply KVL to this second loop. In this second loop, first one, 4 into I2. It's a voltage drop. Minus to plus, it is a voltage rise. This is also the minus to plus, voltage rise. Minus to plus. So this 3 5-volt battery. So these 3 5-volt battery, it is a voltage rise. So 5 plus 5 plus 5, you have to write in one side. It is a voltage rise. Okay. Similarly, the remaining resistance across the voltage across the resistance, it is said to be the drop. Okay. So you have to write the equation. Then you just rearrange, and this is the equation number 2. Okay. Similarly, we have to apply KVL for loop 2. Okay. Always we have to write KVL in the current direction itself. Aba, you start from this battery. So minus to plus, it is a voltage rise. Then when we are coming here, this is also minus to plus. It is also a voltage rise. So 30 plus 5, you have to add. Okay. So 30 plus 5 in one direction. And voltage drop across the resistor, you have to write in another direction. So 8 I3 plus 2 into I3 plus I2. Okay. Since the I2 and I3 is flowing in the same direction, that's why we have to add. Okay. This is the equation number 3. Okay. And what's the next thing? We have to convert equation number 1, 2, 3 into matrix form. Okay. So but from this matrix, we have to determine the del value and the del I1, del I2, del I3. Okay, what is del I1? The del I1 is nothing but in the 3x3 matrix, the first column, this first column is replaced by this constant value. Okay, so 15, 15, 35 with the remaining thing. So the answer is 1530. Similarly, del I2 is nothing but in the 3x3 matrix, replace this second column by this constant value. Del I3 means replace the third column by the constant value. So the del I2 we calculated 1090, and the del I3 it is also calculated as a 1875. So from this we have to find the 3 mesh currents, I1, I2 and I3. So what is the current I1? It's the ratio of del I1 divided by del. So the ratio of the two thing, it is 2.56 amps. Similarly, the current I2 equal to del I2 by del. So the answer is 1.82 amps. The I3 is del I3 divided by del. It is 3.13 amps. Okay. So the 3 mesh currents are calculated. Okay. But our question is to, you see the question, determine the current supplied by each battery. Okay. According to this diagram, you see what is the current supplied by this battery E1? It is a current I1. Okay, so the current supplied by the battery E1 is I1. So you have to note down the answer. Similarly, what is the current supplied by the battery E2? E2 means I1 is flowing in this direction, I2 is flowing in this direction. The current supplied by the battery E2 equal to I2 minus I1. Okay, what is the current supplied by the battery E3? So this E3 is only appearing in the loop 2. So this loop 2 current is said to be the E3 current. So the current supplied by the battery E3, it is said to be the I2 current. Okay. Similarly, current supplied by the battery E5 is, this battery is available only in the last loop. So the current I3. But the current supplied by the battery E4 is, this E4 is appearing between loop 2 and loop 3. And you know, you see the direction, I2 is from this direction. Okay. Minus to plus. I3 is from this plus to minus. But what about the current supplied by the battery E4? It's a I, that is I3. Okay. From here, I3. So it is a I3 value minus I3 value. The current supplied by the battery is I3 plus I2. Okay. So but you see, current supplied by the battery E1 is I1. So you have to note down, current supplied by the battery E2 is I2 minus I1. Current supplied by the battery E3 is only I2. Current supplied by the battery E4 is I3 plus I2. So this one, current supplied by the battery E5 is I3. Okay, so this is the answer for this problem. Okay, so understand. So first one, ordinary mesh analysis. We have to write KVL equation for each mesh. Okay, we have to find out I1, I2, I3. Then after calculating I1, I2, I3, we have to find out current supplied by each battery. But you see, the E1 battery is appearing in only first loop. But what is the current supplied by the battery E1? I1 only. Similarly, this E3 resistance, E3 voltage source is appearing for only loop 2. So the current supplied by the battery E3 is I2. Similarly, current supplied by the battery 30 volt, it is appearing only in loop 3. So it is I3. Okay, these three are same. And the remaining these two battery, you see, the E2 battery is common for loop 1 and loop 2. Okay, that's why the current flowing in this branch, okay, current flowing in this branch is said to be the current supplied by the battery. But that current is I2 minus I1. Similarly, here the current flowing through this branch, it is said to be the current supplied by the battery. So it is a addition of I3 plus I2. Okay, so we solved the these three problems. So this is a mesh analysis problem. So it's a December 2017 question. Okay, thanks for watching. So for more videos, please subscribe my channel.